Hello, this is Mark Pugash from BBC Radio 5 Live. We're in the Madejski for a huge game at the bottom of the Barclays Premier League between Reading and Aston Villa. 3 points for either side will give them a real boost for their run into the rest of the season.
I don't think I have to go into our players on Saturday at 10 to 3 and say, by the way, lads, this is a really important game today. Because they probably suss that themselves. They know how important it is for them, for their families, for the club. So it doesn't need me to reinforce that.
In the header, hits the post, bounces back out, follow-up shot, back of the net. It's Agbon Lahore who smashes it past the stranded Taylor. Right on the stroke of half time, got a minute of stoppage time to go. Villa make it 2-1 against.
So there's the full-time whistle, a massive win for Aston Villa then to take them out of the bottom three. And Villa at home to Queen's Park Rangers next week, who also had a good win today. For Reading though, that's four defeats in a row, and it's going to be a tough run in for them to the end of the season.
Breaking news just coming through in the last couple of minutes that Reading Football Club have announced just now the departure of their manager, Brian McDermott. So effectively, he's been sacked. We've just heard news from the club in the last 30 seconds or so. Owner Anton Zingarevich wishing to place on record his thanks to Brian, who had achieved great success, in his words, with the club since taking over as manager in December 2009.
It was a tough decision because obviously Brian's been at the club for over 10 years, and it's not just the manager decision that I was taking. I was taking the decision of taking a person that's been dedicated and did a lot of hard work for this club out of the club. You know, if it would have been just the manager who was working at the club and I had to replace him, it was one decision. But because Brian was basically what Reading is today, and the success we've had lately was the contributor to that. So of course it was a really tough decision for me, and I was nervous about the whole thing, because obviously I had to talk to him directly, but he was good to me. I mean, all the time that we worked together, we were good to each other, and he knew it, and he told me he told me basically, I understand how difficult it is for you. And it was.
I mean, I've known Brian a long time, and he's a brilliant manager. Record speaks for itself, and whichever club he decides to sort of manage next, they're going to be very lucky. But I've asked to sort of look after the team. So of course we've got to do 100%, 100%, and that's what we'll be doing. So it's a great opportunity. The group, Brian's group have earned that right to take on Manchester United in the Premier League. It's not a cup tie, it's the Premier League. And that is really important and really exciting. If you can't get excited about going to Old Trafford, then there's something wrong with you.
Walked to the coach, ready to travel to Man United. All excited. We'll see how it goes.
We're going up to sunny Manchester.
Who am I room with?
Hattie.
What are we doing on camera here?
Roger.
To get hold of one, it's a foam roller. Every night before I go to bed, I make love to the foam roller. Spend a good half an hour passionately rolling my muscles over this baby. Get involved. Some massive games coming up between now and the end of the season, and you know they're all, you know, cup finals in themselves, really. And we've just got to make sure we're right for every game, whatever that takes.
It was everyone at the club. I second what Joby said. He's been disappointed, and but we are professionals at the end of the day, and we've got big nine games coming up, and so we've had to quickly turn our focus to that. And prepare right for the week for the game on tomorrow, and that's what we've been focusing on.
To be fair to Eamon, he made the point of we've earned the right to play at places like this through what we did last year, and we're here by merit and we deserve to be here. So we've already given a good account of ourselves both time we've played them this year, and we'll be looking to do the same.
All sorts of pain.
I don't really venture over to this side of town that much.
No, I'm only at night time this side of town.
Mm.
So we've proved last season that we've we won the championship, so obviously we must have done something right last year, and we've won enough games, well, we've won five or six games is it, in the Prem this year, and we've picked up enough points to give ourselves a chance. So I think we've obviously got to have the right amount of belief and obviously courage in the way we play. And we've got to show that on the pitch. And I think, obviously, everyone relishes playing against Man United. everyone wants to play against the big teams and show how good they are, and this will be no different for us. It's a no-lose situation for us. We go there, we get beat, everyone expects us to get beat. We go there, get a draw, everyone's saying how good we are. We go there, win, we're the heroes again. So, you know what I mean, like I say, it's no-lose for us. We've just got to go there, play well and give our all and play with bravery, courage and take it from there, and hopefully it'll be good enough on the night.
Someone once said let's go for a walk before a game and it's just stuck from there. I don't know the benefit for it, get fresh air or whatever, but it's a commonplace now in football, isn't it, really? It's one of the upsides of it, I guess, is it's walk around Manchester with me, obviously.
Six games, you slaved away to get here. I like real men's talk, honestly. We all need help. We all need help to make a difference. Forget about the destination. Enjoy the journey. What a great journey it is today for us, for this group today. 80% of elite sport is in there. That is a fact. That is not disputed. So if we think we can come in here and not squeeze everything out and it'll all be okay, we're kidding ourselves. We'll have a few obstacles today. At Old Trafford, of course, and we'll use them, we'll step across those obstacles to get to where we want to get to. Okay? Let's go, yeah?
Too easily, Ferdinand. Here's Rooney into the box, shot deflected to the back of the Reading net. It was a wicked ricochet that looped over Stuart Taylor's head. The Reading goalkeeper left stranded. A goal coming from the McCleary miss-hit pass on the halfway line. Ferdinand strode forward and Rooney, with a deflected shot, puts Manchester United a goal to nil up here at Old Trafford with 21 minutes gone. Referee blows his whistle. That's it. Final whistle's blown. New manager, same old result, I'm afraid. It's a Reading defeat, five in a row. And now the gap at the bottom of the table is looking ominous for Reading.
And they had a fantastic run after Christmas and give themselves a real chance. But 7 points in 8 games to make up, I think it's just a bit too much for them.
Anyone who's been involved at sports, certainly at this level, you know that you never give up until it's over, and it's not over, and we won't give up. So we'll continue to do what we believe in, we'll continue to believe in ourselves, and we'll continue to work as hard as we possibly can.
Already, yeah? Come in. You alright? I'm not alright. Someone, no, the ones that put the tea bag in, and then put the milk in. What's all that about? How can you do that? I'm not sure how strong your tea is. My mate got me. Painted for me. First goal in the Premiership. Doing a celebration. This is my little Hoover. That's my little Hoover. So it comes out like when it's charging at the moment because he's tired. It comes out and cleans the place. needs to get his acting gear, actually.
Don't your dog get your remote control? That's what happens. It was either him or my missus. I'm not sure which one it was. I've got it in my head, like, I'm up at the end of the season. I could go totally one way and say, right, that's it. We're down. I've got to look out for myself. I can't get injured. I've got to be careful. You know, all the things that a lot of people tell you to do, because this is what I do, but I've never once in my life ever thought about that. Like, never thought, right, I'm not going to play into a tackle. I love going into tackles. It's what I do. Like, I love going for headers. I love getting stuck in. I love rolling people up. It's not about me. It's not about me at the end of the season. So, no, it's about the team. And if I didn't think, like I said, we couldn't stay up, I wouldn't be throwing myself out on the line every week. Because I do firmly believe that we have a chance of staying up, 100%. You know, and the boys do as well. You can go through, I'd say on both your hands, you wouldn't get as many shouts for different referees, you know, through the season. Start right to start, Torres' goal. You go through all, Tabby should have a couple of penalties. Joby should have a penalty in one of the games. I should have a penalty. The Demba Ba handball. All these things, you know, that, so it didn't surprise me. Teams that get relegated, people lose jobs. You know, I know there's always someone that has to get relegated, but the fact of the matter is, it might have been down to two or three or four decisions from referees that could effectively, like, lose a lot of people's jobs around the club. You know, whether it be the extra people we brought in to coach, or the extra people we got to you know, to sell programs, you know, or whatever it is. But I don't think they even think about these things, you know, and that's what annoys me, you know. And these decisions, that they're shaking their heads and they're ignoring things, and that's what annoys me. That annoys me that they can just, like, brush it off as if it's nothing, like, when it is something.
First and foremost, I was impressed when I met the owner. I was impressed when I met Nick. It's a good football club. I've met Sir John over the years. I've always known Reading as a very, very good football club. And when we look at it, we're in the Premier League. We've got to make sure that we remain in the Premier League. The stability here, there's a future looking forward. And I'm excited about the prospect of being here. Good conversations we've had, very good conversations, very positive. As I said, I'm really looking forward to the next stage now, moving on. That's what we've got to do. We look to the future. We're at Reading. We're all together. We're all going to work very, very hard. We're all going to pull in the same direction. I think that's the important thing now. You know, it's a great challenge we've got.
The relationship between the owner, the chairman, and the manager is the most important one at a football club, because we have to understand how things are run, and we have to understand where we're going, and we've got to work very hard for each other. The supporters are the football club, aren't they? You know, it's their football club. They want to see players that can go out who are going to be totally committed to the cause. They want to get, you know, they want to be inspired, they want to be off the seats, they want to be able to lift the players. The supporters have got to lift the players. The players have got to lift the supporters. We've all got to be together, and You know, I've had a great relationship with the supporters at Bangor City, Scunthorpe United, Southampton. I'd love to think that we've got a good relationship in store here at Reading. We all want the same thing. We want to be in the Premier League. We want to be successful. And if we can continue all the good work that Brian's set in stone here, then we give ourselves an opportunity to carry that out.
Here at the Emirates and at the end of Nigel Atkins' first game in charge of Reading. It's a real struggle for Reading. Final score here at Arsenal. It's Arsenal 4, Reading 1.
Fans are fans. Now, they have their own problems back at home or at their office or at their place of work. They come to football to get rid of all that and go into a different place. They come to football with the sole purpose of wanting their team to win. That's what fans want, okay? They don't come to draw, they don't come to lose, they come to win. It's their sort of fantasy, their way of getting away from the pain of real life half the time to go into a different world of fantasy and taking them away from the trials and tribulations of life as it is. And they have one thing that they want, and that is to win. They want their team to win. You know, it's jolly difficult, actually, in the Premiership, because you have the leaders in the Premiership that have all the best players throughout the world. And when you're a smaller club trying to compete with these big clubs who have endless resources to draw upon, it is very difficult. I think the thing about our club is the fact that we've always run it in a way that was, can I say, sensible, prudent, let's say. And, you know, we've punched way above our level for many, many years. And I'm very proud of that. And I suppose, if all said and done, we're what you might call a yo-yo club. You know, we get up to the Premiership, we come down, and hopefully we go back up again. But, you know, we're very keen, and so's Anton, on growing our own. That is why great stories put on the academy and so on, because we can't cherry-pick international players from all around the globe. It's far too much of an expensive pastime. I think that, Anton did try his very best to recruit some players at Christmas time, but sadly, for one reason or another, we weren't lucky in establishing any of those players. So I'm afraid we are where we are, but nevertheless, there's great enthusiasm and great determination in the club to work our way back to the top flight of football. We're always on the learning curve. We always get it right in the end, but sometimes you have to go backwards to go forwards again.
Come on, let's go!
He's got the Fondre in the middle. Brilliant from Robson Canoe. Down he goes in the penalty box. And everybody stops, even the Southampton defenders think it should be a penalty. Here comes Southampton again. Getting stronger in this contest. Rodriguez running for a return ball. Federici comes out, can't clear. Southampton go 1-0 up. Rodriguez bumbling straight through the heart of Reading's defence and sliding it past Federici from 8 yards out. Here come Southampton down the middle. Great chance for Lallana and it's scored, tucked home.
You know, they've worked very, very hard, which is important. The desire needs to remain strong. What we'll do is we'll analyse the game over the weekend and take the positive and the lessons we've learned from today's game. And we look forward to working hard on the training ground in preparation for the next game, which is Liverpool.
Orange's turnover now. Swap it over. Think about scanning. Think about the pass of the ball quickly, calmly when we've got it. Think about a flow. If you turn over the ball, can you get the pass away quickly enough to get a flow? Alright? So we're not turning over a turnover. Important thing now. If you gain the ball, get the ball away, get a flow. Good! Good! Now we're playing! Head up!
Yes, Joe!
Good! Head up! Well played!
Yes!
Well played! Good! Pass!
Yeah, so we're in the tunnel now, getting ready for the game against Liverpool. Massive game for us, obviously. Have a lot of quality, Sturridge, Suarez up front. There's not much better than that. But the boys are confident. We have a game plan. We know what we want to do. But of course, we're talking about world-class players here. But we've got a belief we can get something out of the game. If it can start today, and who knows what could happen.
Was terrific from McCarthy all the way up front. An 11-man effort from Reading. Good atmosphere in here, real belief pouring back into the Reading fans.
You know, young Alex made some brilliant saves today, and that's as good a goalkeeper performance I've seen for a long time.
You know, the supporters want to see good attacking football, they want to see football, they want to see winning football, and what we've got to do is work very hard, and the players know that.
55 minutes of Reading football chat ahead of us. Tim Deller with you through until 7 o'clock this evening here on BBC Radio Berkshire. And coming up in the show tonight, we'll hear from new manager Nigel Adkins in depth. The assistant manager Andy Crosby are live from the team hotel in Norwich tonight. Have Reading got any chance at all of survival going into this Norwich game tomorrow? How do you rate their chances of a win? And if both Adam Federici and Alex McCarthy were fit, which one of those two would you give the number one jersey to? If Reading win tomorrow, then no relegation certainty at all this weekend. But if they were to lose and other teams were to lose, then Reading come Monday night could be relegated. But we're all believers here, mate.
Well, we got to believe.
We've got to believe. AD Williams is here tomorrow. He'll be steering you through the build-up to the game. 1-3 tomorrow. Mick and I off up to Carrow Road. Live commentary from Carrow Road here on BBC Radio Berkshire. And we will be positive, mate, won't we?
We're always positive, Tim.
Yeah, we normally have a good crack, and we'll pick our own teams, won't we, on the way there, and yeah. We'll discuss what we think personally. What would you do? Who would you play? And same as all fans, same as when you're on the supporters' coaches or travelling up in a car with supporters. Each supporter, and we are supporters. We'll have our own idea of who we'd play and etc. So we have a sometimes heated debates about no, why would you play him and blah blah blah. So it's good banter, isn't it? Really.
Effectively, it's exactly the same as what we do on air, isn't it? And actually, sometimes the entertaining part comes on the trip on the way up, and actually we just regurgitate what we've done on the car journey between 1 o'clock and 6 o'clock in the afternoon. So it's just, we're exactly the same really, aren't we, just gnashing away about the footy.
Night night, Mick, see you tomorrow.
Night night, Tim.
Nice hotel, yeah. Good view from the room. Not too far to go to the office. Nice day, isn't it?
It's worth checking out, you know. I can imagine standing here watching me chasing Darren Eady. Darren Eady, can you remember Darren Eady?
Yeah, I do remember.
He's one of the quickest players ever, and I actually caught him.
They gave him a penalty and got sent off.
It wasn't a penalty.
He did get sent off.
I caught him just at the edge of the box and got sent off. I was like that. Yeah.
Red card for Gooding.
I caught Darren Eady. How quick am I?
Were you not legitimately though?
No, I did foul him, but...
Yeah, so... I'd like to see them build on what they did last week. I thought they played well in parts last week against Liverpool, so... More of the same. In some ways, the result... Yeah, clearly it's massive, but actually you want to keep on seeing that improvement, don't you?
Well, that's... I think for a lot of the Reading fans who are more realistic than some of the blind, we're going to do it. You know, I'm not knocking those people, but I agree with you. For some of the Reading fans, I think the performance will be as important as the result. Because the results, they're not going to get 5 wins on a spin. But if they can see a progression in the performance, then I think that'll give them lots of optimism for next season.
Decent seat here at Norwich. Right, pretty much on the halfway line. Always nice in the sunshine. Don't know what it is about football grounds, but it looks so much better when it's sunny, doesn't it? Now in towards Kamara, also that hold, another great save from McCarthy. He can't do anything about the follow-up though. Norwich go 1-0 up. McCarthy initially carried out in towards the far post. McCarthy beats it away. Chance for another follow-up and another goal for Norwich, this time turned in by Elliot Bennett. It was similar. McCarthy made the initial save, Bennett picked up the pieces and stuck it from 10 yards out.
Although McCleary comes forward here, left footed this time, super strike.
At the end of last week, and you're relatively upbeat after the performance. Your mood contrasting this week?
I think it's been one of the only games where we've really controlled it. As I said, we've had a lot of chances, me included, and I'm disappointed I didn't get a couple more really. But I suppose we've got to move on to next week.
Victims of their own success. If they'd finished fifth in the championship last year and were kicking around in a similar spot at this time this year,
wouldn't be much fuss. It wouldn't be as much fun, though, would it? The whole roller coaster, the emotional ups and downs, is what sport's all about. We certainly get our fair share of thrills and spills with Reading in the last few years.
Yeah, we do, and I'm not being disrespectful to any team, but if we follow a team that were pretty much mid-table in their respective division season after season after season, then it would become a little bit, for me, it would become a little bit boring. But since, certainly since I've been doing the radio with Tim, there've been some fantastic, memorable moments and some absolutely shockers.
You get your fair share of great moments, and we tend to remember those. You just don't know what you're going to get either. Anyone who can possibly predict where Reading will be in whatever table it may be next season, they've got no idea. I've got no idea. No one knows. It could be anywhere next season, and that's what makes it interesting. That's what makes it worth getting out of bed and having a watch for.
Permutations are actually quite straightforward. Only a win will ensure survival for either of these two teams to fight at least for another day. Lose and one is down. If the game is a draw, they will both go down by virtue of the fact that Wigan and Aston Villa go down.
Ladies and gentlemen, would you welcome the Southlands teams, Queen's Park Rangers and Reading!
It's the final whistle that ends Reading's time in the Premier League for now. Reading are relegated. It's Championship football for them in season 2013/14. It's all over. The Fat Lady is now in full voice.
It was a mixed year. On the one hand, of course, it's not a successful year. It's more far from it. It's a bit disappointing to be relegated, but obviously we have aspirations and we want to be a Premier League club. But you have to take the positives from everything, and I think we're well equipped for the Premier League, spending a year there.
The fact that we've been relegated, and I can see it was a very disappointed and down changing room, one of the worst I've been in after a game, that's for sure. And it's a feeling that we want to make sure we don't experience again, and we've got to try and move on as quickly as possible and as difficult as it is, and try and really now focus on finishing the season well and obviously moving on to next year.
Joby's a great captain, and I think he's a player. Even if he wasn't the captain, I think he's one of those people that you can go and talk to, and he's played the game, he's been around for a long time, and he knows how to look after the young lads, and he gives great advice. And when I needed to talk to him, he was there for me, and luckily I listened to him, yeah. From the offset, we knew it was going to be tough. Coming up to the Premier League from the Championship is going to be a tough task for any team. We give it our best shot, but unfortunately we've been relegated. It's a hard one to take, but if we can keep the core of the squad and keep a lot of the players with the experience, I'm sure we've got every chance going straight back up next year.
I think everybody at the club has to learn from this season. You know, I think when things don't go great, you have to pick out certain areas and look to improve, because there's clearly areas that we need to improve on. The next time we get a chance in the Premier League, and I think from that point of view, you have to use that as a learning exercise, really, and not just the young players, but older players, staff. I'm sure even the owner. Everyone through the club has got lessons to learn from this year, and we'll make sure we're better for it the next time.
I mean, Brian was the guy that signed me. He's the guy that brought me into the club from Swindon and gave me my chance in the Premier League. So I've got a lot to thank him for. And like you said, him being sacked, it was a difficult time for the whole club. Since Nigel's come in, it's been a breath of fresh air, do you know what I mean? We've started to play differently, and we're trying to put his philosophies over on the pitch. And I think you can see the progression in the team week in, week out now.
Disappointing, but not the end of the world. So we've gone down, we can come back up. Could be in a worse financial position. We've got a good manager, good financial backing. We've got some good players, so future could be very bright for Reading, really.
What I expected, it was going to be very, very tough. Didn't expect a great deal. I thought we could, sort of be fourth from, fourth worst team, if that makes sense, and that would have done me. So it's quite disappointing to drop straight down again, but it's just the way it is. It's a tough, tough league, the Premier League, isn't it? So, it's just good fun being up here, but I love the Championship just as well, really.
Robson Kanu at Craven Cottage with a chance to give Reading the lead after 11 minutes. Here he comes, left-footed, very stylishly scores. Hal Robson Kanu's sixth goal of this Premier League season. Falls for Robson Kanu. Robson Kanu left-footed, 2-0 Reading in front of the fans. Hal Robson Kanu buries his brace. Lafondre gets a little nudge in the back, lovely little nod down, makes it 3-1 to Reading. Adam Lafondre breaks the record for most goals scored in a Premier League season by a substitute. Here's a great chance for Karajan. Karajan scores! He buries it into the bottom corner and peels away to celebrate with the Reading fans. 4-2 with 8 minutes of the game left here at Craven Cottage, and a much more cheerful afternoon for those Reading fans.
My guest today is Anton Zingarevic, the new owner of Reading Football Club. I'm delighted to welcome you here, Anton. Welcome to 107. Was it totally different than you ever expected when you came in a year ago?
The biggest difference was that when you sit there watching the game as a fan, you're really just watching the game of football, but when you sit there only in the club, you yes. can't really take it in the same way. You have to be more
thoughtful.
Absolutely. Anton, we're now in the Championship, and we're looking forward now to the close season and improving the squad, no doubt, and there'll be changes and so on and so forth. What can you tell people about your ambition? Is your ambition to get back to the Premiership just as soon as possible? Is that your ambition?
Definitely. The ambition and the objective is to win the league. That's the only thing that we as a football club want to achieve. And we've had board meeting where we discussed that not long time ago. So ooh. I think we all have that message throughout the club where we want to win the league. And I think the key is that everything is there for us to achieve that, because obviously we've done it last season, so the players and the staff and everyone around the club knows what needs to be done for us to win the league. But now we've had the Premier League experience.
I always caught sitting and watch the game. It's when I was younger, I couldn't even go to the games. I've got a bit better over time, and now I'm able to spend time in the dressing room and speak to the boys. And obviously, as you get older as well, you understand the importance of being around and being with the boys. But yeah, as for being outside, I find that tough. We go out there trying to do the best we can. This is a team that is used to success, to win promotion from the position we were in, with the budget we had, the club we were, was a fantastic thing to achieve. And I believe this team will go on and achieve more fantastic things. Yes, there's been a change of manager, there's a change of philosophy, but you know, those are real men in that dressing room, and I believe that they'll come good.
They seal the contest. It's been brilliant to watch. Reading have played their fair part in a very entertaining contest, but with 3 minutes left, it's Reading 0, Manchester City 2.
It was tough. It was frustrating. You know, all the emotions that you do go through as a player. But I was delighted that it was the gaffer that come in, because obviously I've seen his brand of football, his style of play, and I thought, I'll have a chance here. It's fell into place for me personally, because the style we play seems to suit me down to the ground, and obviously I've played all the games under him, which has been nice. And not just personally, I think the team have come a long way from the first game against Arsenal. It's difficult to ask a group to change the style of play in a few days, and it's took weeks and hours on the training ground, and we're sort of getting to where we're trying to go.
From the day one that we've spoke, we understand our viewers the same in terms of what football we need to play and what players need to come in. What we'd like to achieve is to have a stronger team in the championship than we had in the Premier League. So that's the recruitment department has put a lot of hard work into it. We've been, as I said, we've scouted more than 900 games this season. So we've done a lot of preparation for the preseason. Hopefully, come the first game of the season, we have already a group of players and a team that's going to be a strong team and a strong contender.
Come to a hotel, what are you going to do? Just sit in your hotel room and sit around and wait for the game. So there's a lot of opportunity for little sidetracks here and there. But I guess it just shows you don't get none of that with the Reading lads. We're all top professionals, all here to do a job. So around the hotel, everyone's just low-key, super chill. You get to some clubs and in interviews, that's what the player's going to say. Oh, everyone's good lads or whatnot. But here, I've never seen anything like it. The lads are just top notch, all honest, down to earth, just hard working players. You can be who you want, you can talk to anyone, you can say what you want to. Obviously, with respect, but you can talk to anyone and approach anyone and talk about anything.
It's obviously disappointing. We worked hard to get back to 2-2, and we gave away a couple of other stoppy goals, which kind of defined our whole season, so it's frustrating, but we've got a hard slog next year, so we need to come back well prepared for that. I think we just need to stay positive, it's been a tough year, but I think if you said last Christmas that we would be playing in the Premiership, I think everyone would have snapped up, every fan would have snapped their hands off. So just get behind the boys, that's all you can ever do, whether good through bad. If you are a die-hard Reading fan, as a lot of people are, you've just got to take the good times with the bad, and everyone move on together. And we're a great club, we're a family club, and everyone sticks together. And I think that's the main message. We need to all stick together through the good times and the bad times. It's been a bad time this season, but there's many more good times ahead.
When the opportunity was presented to me to come to Reading,
obviously I've thrown Brian up. One to, you know, listen to what he had to say as well about things at Reading Football Club from that point of view. So that was a good conversation. It's pleasing that he's now got himself back in work as well at another football club. Obviously the Arsenal game was a bit of an eye-opener, you know, the perception from outside the football club, looking in, obviously the Arsenal game from my point of view was a big eye-opener in respect of where we were. And obviously it's fair to say, you know, we'd come off the back of an international break and having lost the manager and the players' confidence levels, you could understand to be very low because, you know, we've been on a poor run of results and where we stood in the division. So, you know, we needed to give the players a little bit of direction and build the confidence up. And I must say that they've worked very, very hard. I've had good conversations in the first week with them, individually and collectively. And I must say the attitude and application of the players has been first class. Those in the team and those not in the team. The young pros, the senior pros. You know, they've done really well, and as I say, I'd like to think that it's been demonstrated on the training ground and importantly on the pitch where you've got to pick up the results, that there's been a steady improvement in what we're looking to do moving forward. You know, like anything, things don't happen overnight. You know, you've got to keep building, and it takes a period of time. I know I was at a conference not so long ago, and there's someone from Barcelona stood up and talked, and everyone had been raving about Barcelona, and he said, you've got to remember, it took us 22 years to get to this stage. So things don't happen overnight, and you know, from a football club, if we can keep progressing on everything, great enthusiastic staff here, enthusiastic players, and you know, we allow them to make mistakes, but we've got to keep striving to win, but play football the way that we want to go and play football, which is to control games of football, and to make it exciting, and to score. To win games.
I mean, anyone that knows me and has followed my career will know that, you know, it's the longest time I've spent at a club, and you know, I feel you know, very much part of the club. You know, I've enjoyed my time here immensely, and you know, it's been some ups and downs, you know, along the way. But as I say, those good times are not as good if you haven't had a few, you know, bad moments. And as I say, you've got to overcome them. I say that. Change room after the playoff defeat was a real bad one to be in, and you know, we made sure that we didn't want to go through that again. And you know, the next year we obviously went up as champions, so we'll use this year, as I say, as a you know, a lesson and something to really spur us on for next season.
From the fans' point of view, I think you're talking about a team that did absolutely fantastic to get promotion, absolutely pulled up trees to get the club into the Premier League, where there's a huge financial benefit for the club and for everybody. So I think that has to be applauded first and foremost. Secondly, you need to look at you know, how this season's gone. You've got to look at the way you've gone about it, and the way other people have gone about it. And then thirdly, you need to take on board that is the club in a better position than it was 18 months ago, and I think everyone would say it is.
I don't think I can say any different. We won the league last season, so why shouldn't be any different for us for the next season? And I really feel that we're equipped with a team that can win the league. You know, I watched the playoff games, watched some other games, and the recruitment department watched many games in the championship. And we all feel that the current group of players can win the league. You know, and if we can help them by bringing more players that fit the criteria, I'm sure with all the work that manager is putting in the training ground, I'm sure we'll be the strong contenders to win the league. And I think that's the only thing that we're thinking about, is winning every game.
I think the team will learn from this. I mean, I've been part of a team that's been relegated before, and it's certainly not a nice feeling, but I think you realise the levels you need to go to if you want to be successful. This side, success for this side is not just getting promotion, but staying in the league. But I think you know, different clubs and different teams will take different ways of different models of becoming a Premier League team or a Premier League club. And I think, you know, for us, we'll have to take the sting of this relegation and come back stronger.
So as long as we keep a positive environment around the place to allow players to go and do that, then they will play with a fearless ambition to pass the football. And take them risks, so it is exciting. So it's important, but ultimately, if you're going to come down to Reading, I want to enjoy it. I want people with smiles on their faces. I want them to, you know, if you pay hard-earned cash,
You need to know that the players are going to work hard on the training ground and endeavour to win games of football and entertain. And if you come down, you know, I want you to have smiles on your faces and enjoy the whole occasion. Bring the family down, smile, enjoy, laugh, sing, shout, you know, and you know, come down and have the hospitality that's on offer and make it a real friendly place, but an intimidating place for the opposition, because they know that Reading Football Club, the supporters, are going to get right behind the players all the way through the game. And when we've got the ball, and you know, make it really exciting, noisy place to be.